Hi guys, Nick Jennison for GI. Gigging season is back upon us. The world has opened up to at least a certain extent, and a lot of us are getting out there playing shows again, but not all of us are fortunate enough to be playing in the kind of venues where there's an in-house lighting rig and there's a lighting engineer taking care of all that stuff. Some of us are out there playing in self-contained bands, either in bars or we're doing weddings and functions, where we're expected to bring our own PA system and also our own lights. Maybe you're a solo performer who's doing a similar sort of thing. And lighting can be a bit of a mystery and it's often a little bit overlooked, but it is absolutely crucial to, in my opinion, at least crucial to the success of your show, because lighting really kind of sets the mood for the music that you're playing. It really helps people engage with what you're doing. So we're going to take a look at a real simple solution to this today, which is the Kam Power Partybar WFS, which stands for Wireless Foot Switch. More on that in a moment. What this basically is a bar that has power in it, hence power, and it also has four of these guys. These are LED power cans. They're basically a three-color LED, which gives you any combination of colors you can imagine. Obviously, you can have purple, green, yellow, red, etc., etc., and also a fairly convincing white too. We've got four of them. You can move them in a bunch of different axes, point them at whatever you want. One of these is going to be enough to light up a small band, or if you have two of them, you can position them either side of the stage. You can get a good spread of light across maybe a larger stage front. So let's fire it up. We'll take a look at what it does onto our back wall. So here in auto mode, there's three real kind of like modes of operation here. We have a fixed color mode, an auto mode, which is just going to flick between colors kind of as the party bar sees fit. There's a few different programs you can use. And we also have a sound to music mode that we'll explore in a moment. But let's take a look at the positioning real quick. So you can see the dots of these power cans. Now we're pretty close to this wall, but if you pull it out a little bit further, you can get a real good spread of light at one of these. Again, we're pretty close to our back wall here, but just so you can see how easy it is to move these around. So let's say you had a drummer down here, a bass player somewhere over this way, guitar player over here, your singer wants two lights on them because they're a singer. You get the gist. So you can kind of move these about, position them however you want. Now let's talk a little bit more about some more of the modes of operation. Before we do that, actually, let's take a look at the back panel. So what we have going on here, from this end to this end, we have DMX in and out, because you can control these by DMX. So if you have a more complicated DMX setup, this is kind of a really nice way to integrate just some colored power cans into that setup. You can also use this as a master DMX device to synchronize to other party bars. So if you have two either side of the stage, you want them doing the same thing, you can synchronize them, which is quite cool. We have a Euro lead in and also an out if you want to power two bars or more from the same outlet. One criticism I have of this piece of kit is that the included Euro lead is absolutely tiny, right? It's not tiny by standards of, say, an amplifier, but this is going to be up on a speaker pole or up on a tripod stand. You'll need a long Euro lead, and the one they've bundled in is pretty short, so you're going to want your own. Over here, we've got a microphone and a sensitivity control for the sound to music mode. That's just going to control how sensitive it is, whether you want every little thing to set off a change, or maybe you just want the drummer's kick drum to set off a change in the lights. That's something you can control here. And over here, we've got a numeric display and a series of buttons that's going to enable us to control how the party bar operates. So let's get into that. There's a few modes we can select. We have an auto mode, a sound to music mode, a color mode, which is just going to be a fixed color. We then have a sync mode, which we can use to synchronize between a bunch of different party bars. We can set it up to be a DMX master, or we can set it up to receive DMX commands, which is pretty cool. So you can control that off an external DMX controller or another party bar. And then we've got a system mode, which also enables us to sync up things like the wireless foot switch. And we can do things like tests and all that sort of stuff, make sure our bar is in good health over, you know, the duration of its lifespan. Which brings me to the foot switch. So this comes bundled with a wireless foot switch, which is really useful because it means you're gonna give it to whichever member of your band's not busy at the time. Usually the bass player seems to get this. It's one of those things. I think bass players tend to stand in one spot more than guitar players and drummers, and not drummers at least, more than guitar players and singers, because, you know, we tend to be show-offs. Drummers, their feet are busy, so bass players tend to get the controls. Anyway, what we've got here is controls for blackout. We can set it to auto mode, we can set it to sound to music mode, more on that in a moment, or a fixed color, like this. And our fixed color is going to enable us to scroll between the various colors just to pick a mood for whatever it is that we're playing at the time. And of course, the all important blackout for the end of the song. So that's a pretty simplistic control, but it's going to give you some control over the light show. If you wanted to get a little more in detail, we can do that on the back here. So let's take a look at, for example, color mode. If we get into color, we can set values for the red, green, and blue LEDs respectively. So we can get a fairly convincing white, or we could, for example, pull the red out, so we get this kind of teal color. If then we pull the green out, we get a fixed blue, and so on and so forth. We can also set it to something like sound to music. Let's set that up. And that is gonna change depending upon the sensitivity control. So if I turn the sensitivity control up way high and start clapping, you can hear that's gonna change along with my claps. If I set it a little low, nothing. So that's really going to be kind of like, it's probably going to set off on a big bass thud, like a kick drum, let's say. So somewhere in between. If we get too high, then every little sound is going to set it off. It's going to start going crazy. But there's loads of different functions you can do with this as well. So you can, loads of different modes rather. So what we can do, if we dig in here a little bit deeper, we can set different patterns depending upon, you know, what we want to happen when the music's playing. Let's try this one. Like this one. And again, we can scroll between those on our foot switch. So that's gonna enable us once again. Shows you how rugged the foot switch is too. You can use it to set the sound to music mode off. So there you go, guys. This has been a little bit of a brief look at the Kam Party Bar WFS. It's not a terribly deep product, and that is a good thing, because to be honest, when it comes to setting lights up, you just want to plug them in and have them work. Unless you're a lighting engineer, in which case, you know, you're going to have some big all singing, all dancing, fancy lights and a DMX controller. This can integrate with that too, but if you're a self-contained band that just wants some lights and you just want to be able to operate them with your feet, you know, you can do a lot worse than looking at something like this. Once more, this is the Kam Party Bar, Power Party Bar even, WFS. My name's Nick Jennison for GI. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, be sure to check out the links that you can see right here for more videos on more of the same. I'm sure you're gonna like them just as much. Also, don't forget to click the like and subscribe buttons, which are somewhere down here, and this little bell icon, which is gonna let us notify you when we drop new videos. And you can check out the exclusive lesson platform, GI Plus, which is available at the link in the description. I think you're gonna love it.